10-year note yields closed below 160 for the first time since October, and likely not the last. We've seen a big push lower in yield, higher in price recently, not only based on what we've been seeing over the last week or so from the coronavirus, which has spread throughout the globe and is putting global growth at risk. We're also getting it from central banks. We're getting mixed data. And there continues to be this buy stock momentum that pushes stocks higher for very little reason at this point. Obviously, we have earnings season, but I think that's also aiding in some of the bond buying. It's more defensive. So at this point, we're starting to see more of a breakout trade in the bond market as it has held its range for quite some time, despite the fact that equities have been very bullish, despite the fact that the central bankers have said, hey, everything's okay. Bond market has not been buying into that. And obviously now we're seeing why. There is risk in the market. Now we're seeing yields go down to levels not seen over the last 4 months. And at this point, I think 150 becomes a very real test, a very real possibility that we test that level. And that will be critical if we break through there. Volatility in the bond market, it remains elevated as it should as we're nearing the breakout of a range. At this point, anything we see yields go back higher, it will see volatility go lower and vice versa. Not high off the charts like we would have expected, but as long as we stay south of 160 and start nearing that 150 mark, volatility will get a bid and it will be pretty strong. And lastly, let's talk about the FOMC. What did they say today? Well, they said they want to keep rates steady, and they did. They want to continue to monitor the economy, and they will. And I think that's code for they don't know what they're doing as far as when they're going to have to cut. Certainly a rate hike is not in the cards, but a rate cut could be if things don't get better. They talked about the virus, they talked about China, they talked about trade. And I think at this point, if any of those falter or start to bring in a negative pitch to the economy, they're going to stand ready to cut rates again, possibly by mid-year. So at this point, the Fed remains kind of in limbo, waiting for something to happen. And the Fed waiting for something to happen means they're not acting. And at this point, they're going to continue to support the front end of the curve. They're going to continue to monitor the economy. But it's only if something happens will they react. And a Fed that reacts is kind of an uncertain Fed. And the markets do not like uncertainty from their central bank.